Project presents Wet Inner Gas Generator Part 1.
Hello everyone, see you back in my channel. This video is the series of inner gas system. After previously we have discussed about dry inner gas generator for gas tankers, at this time we will discuss about wet inner gas generator, one of the most widely used system for oil tankers in ensuring safe cargo handling and preventing explosion. In this first part for wet inner gas generator, we will look at its main components and working principles of wet inner gas generator. And by the end of this session, you will have a clear understanding of wet inner gas generator components and its function to keep cargo tanks safe by controlling oxygen levels and preventing flammable atmospheres. So, let's begin our journey into the world of tanker safety with the wet inner gas generator, part 1. Let's go!
Components of inner gas generator. On oil tanker vessels, there are several wet type inner gas system being used. The following is one of the various type of wet type inner gas generator. In principle, wet type IGG working system is the same with dry type, except for drying process. Wet type IGG does not require drying for its inner gas. Basically, the working sequence are as follow: combustion, cleaning, and cooling. Following is the part name of wet IGG. IGG scrubber seawater supply pump to supply seawater to scrubber tower for cooling and cleaning purposes. Deck water seal seawater supply pump to supply seawater for deck water seal. Bilge tank to collect oily water from scrubber when flame fail occur. Seawater drain valve to bilge tank. This valve used for automatically draining seawater from scrubber in case of flame failure occur to prevent oil pollution. Scrubber seawater overboard valve, the outlet of seawater from scrubber to overboard. Deck water seal seawater overboard valve, the outlet of seawater from deck water seal to overboard. IGG blower. There are two sets of IGG blowers to supply combustion air to combustion chamber. The blower type can be centrifugal fan type or screw type. IGG fuel supply pump to supply fuel to main and pilot burner for combustion. Cyclist to check the fire condition of the combustion. Flame detector to detect DP sense of flame in the burner and that a stable flame is burning. Pilot burner provide a small stable flame that ignited electrically to ignite the main burner safely and reliably. Main burner performs the main combustion process by burning fuel and air to produce hot fuel gases. Combustion air funnel. This funnel used to allow combustion air swirling. Swirling creates turbulence, which makes fuel and air more thoroughly. Better mixing air and fuel leads to complete combustion, reducing unburned fuel and emission. Rubber or copper. Spray water manifold where the several nozzles attach. These nozzles used for spraying water to capture, cool, and remove pollutants such as sulfur oxide or SOx, dust, or particulate matter from exhaust gases. Top demister. The demister captures and removes entrained mist, ensuring dry and cleaner gas exit the scrubber stack before delivered to cargo tank. Combustion chamber inner shell. Spiral jacket. The spiral plates force the cooling water or jacket water to follow spiral path instead of strike line. It ensures uniform distribution of coolant across the jacket surface. Bottom demister. To remove entrained liquid droplets or mist from the gas stream exiting the combustion chamber. Combustion chamber outer shell. Buffer plate acts as a flame holder or flame stabilizer, helps maintain a stable flame by providing a surface where the flame can anchor, especially during low load or turbulent condition. Observation side glass. Scrubber cooling seawater inlet valve. Jacket cooling seawater inlet valve. Inner gas generator control panel. Inner gas generator scrubber outlet valve. inner gas generator ventilation to atmosphere. Inner gas generator ventilation valve to atmosphere. Inner gas generator supply valve to cargo tanks. Deck water seal is a safety device installed to prevent the backflow of flammable gases from cargo tanks into the inner gas generator or engine room. This is the internal part of wet type deck water seal. Level width. Level gates. There are three types of deck water seal. One, wet type. When the inner gas plant is operating, the gas bubbles through the water from the submerged inner gas inlet pipe. But if the tank pressure exceeds the pressure in the inner gas inlet line, the water is pressed up into inlet pipe and thus prevents backflow. The drawback of this type of water seal is that water droplets may be carried over with the inner gas, although it does not impair the quality of the inner gas. It could increase corrosion. A demister should therefore be fitted in the gas outlet from the water seal to reduce any carryover. Two, dry type. The water is drained when the inner gas plant is in operation or gas flowing to the tanks, and filled with water when the inner gas plant is either shut down or the tank pressure exceeds the inner gas blower discharge pressure. Filling and drainage are performed by automatically operated valves controlled by the levels in the water seal and drop tanks, also by the operating slits of the blowers. The advantage of this type is that the water carryover is prevented. The drawback could be in the risk of failure of the automatically controlled valves, which may render the water seal ineffective. 3. Semi-dry type. Instead of bubbling through the water trap, the inner gas flow draws the sealing water into a separate holding chamber by Venturi action. Choose avoiding or at least reducing the amount of water droplets being carried over. Otherwise, it is functionally the same as wet type. The Venturi effect is the reduction in fluid pressure that results when a fluid flows through a constricted section of pipe. Pressure vacuum breaker or PV breaker acts as a backup to the pressure vacuum relief valve. It provides emergency relief if tank pressure or vacuum exceeds safe limits. The PV breaker valve used for controlling the over or under pressurization of the cargo tank. The PV breaker fan is equipped with a flame trap to prevent a fire from igniting while in port during loading or discharging operations. Fan mass riser is used for maintaining a positive pressure of inner gas at the time of loading of cargo and during the loading time. It is kept open to avoid pressurization of the cargo tank. Pressure vacuum relief valve. It protects the cargo tank from overpressure or vacuum during loading, discharging, or thermal expansion or contraction. It is installed on top of each cargo tank or common fan line. Primary instrument of safety device to keep tank pressure within safe limits. Provides a safe discharge point above deck level to prevent flammable vapor accumulation on deck.
This is the end of wet inert gas generator part 1. We have learned what it is, why it's important, and the component that make it work. In the next part, we will go deeper into the detailed operation, system flow, and safety consideration. Anyway, thank you for watching my video, and if you found that this video is helpful, don't forget to click like, subscribe, and share button. And don't forget to click bell button so you will be notified when part 2 is released. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.
Be sure to click the subscribe button to my channel. That is the best way to support what I do to share knowledge. Surely, your subscription is fuel bunkering to my brain. It will boost up my energy, stay high level. If you have any question or suggestion, please leave your comments down below.
Thank you for watching my video. Terima kasih, The Antonio Project.